When thinking of the costliest substances on Earth, some people think of gold or platinum, while others think about diamonds. However, the costliest substance on Earth is actually antimatter. And despite the amounts we know about this substance, it still holds a vast number of secrets locked up, waiting to be unveiled. So, what is antimatter? And here is the mystery of baryon asymmetry. Mathematics had predicted the presence of a substance that would have properties similar to that of the particles of regular matter, but with opposite charges. Every antimatter particle has the same mass as that of the regular matter counterpart, and interacts with all four fundamental forces in the exact same way, except for a few exceptions. These substances would annihilate whenever they came in contact with their regular matter counterparts, releasing all of their mass in the form of pure massless energy. These particles were called antimatter and have not just been detected, but also experimented on and used for various applications, especially in the medical industry. Every elementary particle present in the standard model has an antimatter counterpart. In some cases, like some bosons such as photons, the particles are their own antimatter counterpart, and that is all right, as they're already massless forms of energy. However, certain other particles like neutrinos may be Majorana fermions, which are fermions that are their own antimatter counterparts. Antimatter particles annihilate with only their own matter counterparts. This means that there can be other particles formed by the combination of one matter particle and an antimatter particle as long as they are different base particles. For example, mesons are formed when equal number of quarks bind with anti-quarks through strong nuclear interactions. A more specific example could be the kaon, also known as the K-meson, which is formed by an up quark with an anti-strange quark, or its antimatter equivalent, an anti-up quark with a strange quark. Antimatter particles can be found in nature through various processes, including supernova explosions or even at-home radioactive decay. Bananas happen to be radioactive due to the presence of potassium-40, and hence they also produce a very little amount of positrons, which are the antimatter counterparts of electrons. Apart from natural sources, humans have also been able to produce and detect antimatter particles by colliding particles together at really high energies in experiments such as the Large Hadron Collider, or the LHC. Scientists have also been able to produce antimatter atoms. For example, by bringing together anti-up and anti-down quarks to form antiprotons, and then combining these with positrons, scientists were able to create anti-hydrogen atoms. However, the price of creating just 1 gram of any antimatter substance is estimated to be around $62.5 trillion. Despite the price, containing antimatter is not a trivial task. They would annihilate on touching any matter particles, or even the walls of the container, and hence need to be stored in pure vacuum with carefully placed strong electric and magnetic fields. In 2011, scientists were able to trap 309 anti-hydrogen atoms for about 1,000 seconds, but storing them for longer is notoriously difficult. However, all known methods of producing matter or antimatter from energy always leads to there being equal amounts of both matter and antimatter particles. This means that the universe should have equal amounts of both kinds of matter. Despite that, as far as we can see in the observable universe, there is far more matter than antimatter. So much so that we can state that the universe is almost entirely made up of regular matter only. This raises a huge problem in our current understanding of physics, as something must have allowed for matter to exist in quantities greater than antimatter. This discrepancy is what is known as baryon asymmetry. Baryons are particles that are made up of an odd number of quarks, such as our protons and neutrons, and they are what make up almost all of the regular matter that we can see in the universe. However, there should have been equal amounts of antibaryons as well, and that just doesn't exist as per our observations of the universe. This not only puzzled scientists for decades now, but also continues to puzzle them to this day. There were a few hypotheses made to try and debunk this issue, but they all have their own problems. One such suggestion was that antimatter resides in areas of the universe without matter. These areas would have anti-planets, anti-stars, and anti-galaxies. But if this was true, there would be a lot of matter-antimatter annihilation occurring at the border of these two regions of space, emitting vast amounts of radiation that would have been detectable here on Earth. Yet, no such detections were made. Even then, the probability of matter and antimatter forming regions of more matter and no antimatter, and vice versa, seems to be a little too less to be considered valid. As research continued, scientists concluded that there must be some mechanism in nature that behaves fundamentally different for antimatter than matter, which results in this asymmetry. Scientists were able to find out that such a discrepancy does exist in the weak force. The universe treats antimatter and matter differently during the decay of certain particles like the strange quark. However, even with this distinction made by nature, the asymmetry still cannot be fully explained. So finally, the best explanation we have for now is that during the early stages of the universe, the energies were so high that physics itself obeyed other laws that we are currently unaware of. These laws, used to describe the universe today, might have been slightly different, with other extra conditions that cannot be experimentally verified as of now. It's likely that we'll have to solve this mystery theoretically rather than experimentally, with newer and more accurate frameworks to describe our reality. Thank you for watching, and hopefully this video taught you something along the way. Future videos regarding these topics will go into the fundamental symmetries of nature and the many surprises that scientists have had while dealing with them. If you have any requests, queries, or suggestions, do comment them down below and we'll respond to as many as possible. While you wait for the next video to come out, stay notified with regular facts by following Fizzy Facts on Instagram. And don't forget to share this video to help spread the knowledge and make the world a better place. Until next time, stay tuned, stay safe, and be ready to keep learning. Thank you.